Many years ago, high in the Carpathian Mountains, there lived one whose name was to become legend as king of all the vampires, Count Dracula of Transylvania. But now, in this first half of the 20th century, the searching light of civilization spreading from the west has driven him from his stronghold, driven him further east, across desert and mountain range, until now all trace of him has been lost. It is the opinion of those in authority that he is dead, finally destroyed forever. It is also the opinion of others not draped in the cloak of officialdom that he lies hidden in some remote corner of the world, waiting. Waiting for his next victim. Howrah Railway Station, Northwest India, 1934. Penny Woods, young, fresh, and very attractive, but at this moment looking very bewildered, not a little alarmed, is hemmed in on all sides, looking around for someone who might possibly help her.
Please, which is the Mabad train?
Mabad?
Do you speak English?
Yes, I speak it. Mabad train?
My ticket.
Ah, Mahabad. Mahabad train, over there.
Where?
There. See, you have just missed it.
Oh, no. When's the next one?
Wednesday, at the same time. Hey! You cannot do that! It is forbidden!
Quick! Take my hand!
Oh, thank you! Thank you!
Penny finds herself in the dusty corridor of a first-class compartment, clutching her case and her ticket. The first compartment she comes to has the blinds down. She tentatively tries the handle, but drops it when there's a sharp call of disapproval from within.
Occupied.
Sorry.
She moves on to the next. Seated on one side of the compartment, his bare feet drawn up under him, surrounded by pots, jars, bundles, and packages, is a large, overweight Bengali man. This is Babu. On the opposite side is a young couple, the boy in Western clothes, the girl in traditional sari. As Penny appears, the girl turns shyly away. The boy gives her a big smile of welcome.
Excuse me, is there a place free?
Yes, come in.
Yes, of course, my dear young lady, come. Sit by me. You will be quite safe. These charming young people will be your chaperones. You cannot be too careful, you know. There are some pretty funny fellows about now, I can tell you.
Please. The young man takes Penny's case from her and puts it on the luggage rack above. For a moment, their eyes meet. He gives her a boyish grin. Babu waves an admonishing finger.
Ah, I know what you are thinking. He's just an old fuddy-duddy, isn't it?
Please believe me, sir. I thought nothing of the sort.
Here I am babbling on without the common courtesy to introduce myself. Mukherjee, a merchant from Kolkata. But call me Babu.
Oh, hello. I'm Penny Woods from London.
I'm Prem Gopal. This is my sister, Lakshmi.
The Indian girl gives a little bow and smiles a ravishing smile.
How far are you travelling, Miss Woods? Please, call me Penny. To Mahabad.
Then you will be travelling through the night?
So I gather.
But where is your bedroll? Your dhari? Your blanket?
I haven't any.
That is all your luggage?
Yes.
How long will you be staying in Mahabad?
I really don't know. A week or two, perhaps?
Then where are your clothes?
Well, they're all in my case. My heavens.
We are only staying one night, and look at my sister's luggage.
I am an artiste. How do I know what my mood will be tomorrow night? What I shall dance? What costume I shall need?
I am a musician, but I only bring one sitar, not an orchestra.
Because the sitar is the only thing you can play. That's why.
Children!
Sorry. We are going to Mahabad to perform before the Maharaja.
For the one night?
He will pay us well.
And I am returning to my summer home in the hills. And I shall be jolly glad to be there, I can tell you.
May I ask why you are going to Mahabad, Miss Penny?
I don't quite know.
You are going, but you do not know why?
I know, it sounds odd. I've recently come into a legacy. Not a fortune, just enough to let me wander about the world for a while. I landed in Calcutta this morning. I knew it would be hot, of course, but, well, I nearly passed out. I just went to the station and asked for a ticket for the nearest cool place. I've really no idea where Mahabad is, even. It sounds crazy, I know.
You have no friends in India?
Only you.
My heaven.
I think it is quite wonderful. Congratulations.
If we pass anything of special interest, anything unusual, would you point it out to me?
My dear young lady, the most interesting and unusual thing I can see at this moment is yourself.
Penny stands in the corridor, relaxed and at peace, smoking a cigarette and watching the spectacular countryside unroll. In the background, Prem is playing a soulful song on his sitar. Penny turns for a moment and idly glances into the next compartment. On the floor, a servant in immaculate white uniform is setting out a meal for his master, serving it on plates that look suspiciously like solid gold, with spotless white linen. Seated in one corner is a solitary figure, with fair complexion and jet-black hair. He sits bolt upright, looking neither to right nor left, staring straight ahead as if unaware of anything around him. Then, almost as if sensing Penny's fascinated gaze, he slowly turns his head and stares at her. But his eyes are devoid of life. Dead, their soul fled from them. Penny cannot tear her gaze away. The servant, seeing that his master is not drinking, turns towards Penny, and we glimpse for a brief moment the hideous scar that runs across his face, distorting the skin, blinding one eye. Then, furious, the servant reaches up and jerks down the blind in Penny's face. Penny turns away and gives a little cry of alarm as she finds herself next to somebody.
He doesn't intend to starve, does he?
You're right. Who is he? Do you know?
He came to see Lakshmi dance in Calcutta. He gave us this job.
As the sun sets, the train passes a lake fringed with palms. The setting sun sets the still water alight with a deep red glow.
This is the best time to see India. At dusk, with all the hard edges softened.
In the darkened compartment, everyone is now asleep under their blankets. Penny huddled under the bright sari loaned to her by Lakshmi. Her eyes are flickering, and we hear the voice of a girl.
Yesterday, we went to visit the Kubaya Caves, and they have them.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.